And that went on for an entire summer.
I didn't say, you know what, let me do all I can to better myself today. I said, let me do all I can to get fucked up today, to make a memory, to make a picture, to have something to look back on and laugh. If I died, I wouldn't have been laughing no more. My mother and father and brothers wouldn't be laughing no more. My friends wouldn't be laughing no more. September 13th, 2006. I was arrested on my front porch because I gave up. I went home after a long day, a long night. I knocked on the doors were locked. My mother said, here's a sweatshirt, the cops have a warrant for your arrest. So now we're making the right turn onto Carmen Avenue, which if you live in Nassau County and live the life I led is notorious because you got the hospital and you got Nassau County Jail. I remember coming on the bus here from court, scared out of my mind. It was my second visit here, but this time I knew I was gonna be there for a while. And you gotta remain your composure. You can't let people see you be weak. You can't have any weaknesses when you're in jail. If you do, they'll take advantage of it. So I had to try to remain strong, handcuffed next to a real big dude. And I try to block it out of my mind, but it's important to remember like that, things like that. It's important to know that's where it could lead. For 2.5 months, and by the grace of God, was given an opportunity to go to a program. That treatment program saved my life. It taught me how to live again, it taught me how to love again, it taught me how to be an adult, it taught me how to be a man.
Daytop, treatment, recovery, whatever your methodology is, if you want it, you can get it. That's what it taught me. If you want this, you can get this. Just work hard. And I've been working hard for the last 2.5 years. And now I serve the underserved. I serve kids who are just like me. From suburbia in Long Island. I'm a clinical counselor and I love what I do. And I do therapy with kids and it's amazing. My favorite line in the world is, once in a while you can get shown the light in the strangest of places if you look at it right. And I was shown the light from Nassau County Jail to Far Rockaway, Queens, to Swan Lake, New York, to Bryant Park, Manhattan, to 1130 Little Round Neck, where I live again.
It's one night. We, a bunch of people that hadn't really talked since high school all went out together and, you know, everyone was drinking and singing karaoke and, you know, how loose everyone gets with that. And Kevin was just as wild as all of us and cracking all of us up, and he was drinking 7-Ups the whole time. So, I mean, at the end of the night when everyone's going home lit and Kevin's able to, you know, designate a driver everyone home and had been the life of the party the whole night, you're like, holy shit, not only has he kicked it, he doesn't have to do this stuff anymore and to have fun. And you know what, you know, it makes you think about yourself. Wow, I need to drink 6 beers to get loose. And this kid's going out and belting out Paradise by the Dashboard Lights on a ginger ale. So, I mean, you see, I saw definite change and definite sincerity that he's a totally new person, but I come full circle. It was to the same happy-go-lucky kid that I had met back when we were like 12, 13 years old. And had left for a while, but he was back.
I've seen a small piece of what addiction can do. But I lived a major piece. And my family lived a major piece. And my friends lived a major piece. And those close to me lived a major piece of what this disease and what these drugs and what alcohol, very misconceived that it absolutely is a dangerous and toxic poison. And I'm glad where I'm at today. Just trying to find my way back home.
Yeah, right, cause I've been traveling on this road too long. Just trying to find my way.